What up, guys? Welcome to Chef Vic, and today I'm going to show you guys how to make a perfect burger buns. So stay tuned and enjoy, guys. So the burger buns recipe I like to use is a brioche type of dough that's very rich, buttery, and very flavorful for your burgers or anything you want to use them for. So to start this off, we're going to start off with 2 1/4 cups of flour. And for that though, it's always good to get your yeast nice and hydrated and blooming. That's called blooming the yeast. It gets your yeast more active, especially using commercial type of yeast. So to that, we're gonna add about 1/4 cup or so of warm room temperature water, just like that. And then 1 teaspoon of yeast. Got a little sugar right here, just a pinch. Then give you that little whisk it in. So, got your egg yolks in here, 8 of them. And then to that, you guys are going to add your sugar. And then you want to get some milk, about 3/4 cup of milk. And 1 tablespoon extra. Just like that. Next, flour. I use bread flour for my brioche. Has good gluten development into your flour. Extra yeast, 1 tablespoon. And 3/4 of a salt into your stuff. Then you know, put this right in here. And then your yeast mixture. Well, you can see it's fully developed right here. Into there. And then attach your dough hook. Really recommend use a stand mixer. It will be better when you mix up the dough with the butter. So I got my butter here. You're going to need 8 tablespoons of unsalted butter. Then you're going to add them a little bit at a time to incorporate that butter. So my recipe is going to require you to have room temperature butter. Just because it's be easier to blend into the dough better. But I like using somewhat a full dough because this mixture will create heat. You want this to create heat because you don't want your dough too hot. So by adding the butter, it cools it down, but yet incorporating it. It takes a little more longer, but trust me, it's really easy to do this. There you talk. The brioche dough is always going to be kind of tacky. It's never going to be not sticking to your hands and stuff like that. So how can you not let that stick your hand? You gotta go good old friend, a little bit of oil in your hands. I use a little spray, it's a little easier. But just get a bottle of oil and like spray your hand. Looks like so. And then take out your bench scraper. This. A nice beautiful dough though. Look at this. Nice gluten development. Here we go. You have a pretty brioche right there. Now you can make a loaf after it's done resting. Now, you're gonna notice your dough has this beautiful little like tight skin. That's what you want. That's how you know your gluten is fully developed. Besides my oily hand, it's still kind of tacky to the finish. That's what you want. Remember, brioche is its own little type of bread that is very, very delicious. It's not an act like normal breads because this bread is very rich. The gluten development just takes a bit. So be patient with this dough, guys. Trust me, I got mad a couple times when I was making this dough. Learn patience. But put your dough in. As I said, that this dough takes longer to knead it, it also takes longer to rise. At this point, it's up to you. You want more flavor into this dough. Ooh, it's light. And more flavor develop in this dough. Put a nice grease sheet pan or even like a Ziploc bag or grease some plastic wrap. Wrap it up, put in Ziploc bag so it doesn't explode and just ease out. Put it in the fridge and let it rise in the fridge for 24 hours or overnight. And reason that is, it also makes the dough easier to work with when you take it out and shape the dough to what you want to make. I'm gonna leave this room temperature, and that's perfectly fine too. I've done it before. All you probably need is a little more flour to shape your dough and stuff like that. So, it takes longer to rise. So you get the 24 hours option, especially if you don't have time. Or your other option is to let it rise for 1.5 hours to 2 hours. Right. All right, guys. Brioche dough is nice and fluffy. Now it's time to shape these guys. So, to do so, get some nice, beautiful flour. Then, take the air off. Okay. I like to sprinkle a little flour right here. It helps it out. And then, cut the dough. Ooh, pretty. It's a pretty little pillow, isn't it? Then, you want to do... Oh, by the way, this makes awesome cinnamon rolls. Same. Or French toast. Guys, that's the portioning of the dough. So it's now time for shaping the dough. So, get your dough balls, tuck them inside, and in itself. Kind of like the center. Okay, like that. And then you're gonna roll the dough, just like that. Sorry, my little countertop here moves a lot, so be patient. All right, guys, so. That's what they look like that. And then what I did is after you shape them in the balls, I kind of flatten them out like this. And what that does, it tells the dough to rise and almost shape as the burgers. So this is the part you put the molds in. When you make the molds, make them a little bigger, about this thick wide, or have molds like that. So when they rise to that size of the mold. If your molds are smaller, so make the portions of your dough smaller, and then you press them down and then rise, and you see a perfect uniform burger bun. But in this case, this is fine. It'll be quite delicious anyways. So you're gonna let this rise for at least about another hour. So you want that to rise about another hour, guys, and then that will be ready to go. So when it's done, ready to go, I'm gonna show you guys what to do. We're gonna brush them AWASH and bake them to nice and golden brown. Here they are, guys, the brioche burger buns. This is the bagel everything seasoning, and this is the regular. So, some are pretty, some are oddly shaped, but that's what happens. You do freeform rolling of the dough and stuff like that. That's what I recommended. And you use a little ring mold. It will keep them more uniform and perfect shape as a regular burger bun you see in the stores. But hey, and then crack this guy open. Look at that. All right, guys. So that was the burger buns right there. Hope you guys enjoyed. Again, this dough gets kind of a little sticky and stuff like that. So just be patient with it where you're kneading it in the mixer. I do not recommend doing it by hand. Trust me, that is a lot of work and messy job. So please use a mixer with a dough hook. That will help you guys develop the gluten that it needs for this dough. So yeah. So hope you guys enjoy this video. Hit that like, hit the subscribe, and there will be more videos to come on your guys' way. So stay safe, guys. Stay healthy, and I will see you guys.